Hello everybody and welcome to another Train Simulator 2016 video. Yes, I am back off my holidays, and as you may have noticed, we are driving on the South Wales coastal route. I've said it for a while, I was going to purchase this route, and I have as soon as I came back. And today we're going to be driving the Arriva Trains Wales Class 143. One of the scenarios that came with the pack, because of course that's using the 158 and 153 pack added on to the South Wales coastal route. Anyway, let's get back to what the message says. This service has just arrived at Cadicot. Open the doors and allow passengers to board. You can then depart and head to your next scheduled stop at Seven Tunnel Junction. So let's close that. Let's open the doors. And let's have a look at this lovely train. So we can see it, beautiful. Has it a lovely look. Take that hub away. Put those wipers on. You gotta be able to see something. So this put it in gear. Cancel that. Trying to work out where the guard buzzer is. I can't see that, and I was also trying to turn the instrument lights on. Lovely pace of sound. Passing another pace on the way down. Still haven't found the instrument lights. Hopefully we'll find it very soon. Is it wiper switch? Dashboard lights, there we go, that's what we needed. So yes, you may have known the class excuse me. The class 143 came originally with the in First Great Western livery on the Riviera line. Of course it's been reskinned and reworked a little to now be in a Arriva Trains Wales livery and to work on this beautiful route. Well, that 7 Tunnel Junction does look very realistic, I have to admit, compared to the Western Main Lines route by Just Trains. Looks more realistic than the one that they had, that what they made. So let's stop our train here. Get over the 3-car mark a bit. It's more realistic as well. You may also notice, like, the back out. The platform signs are platform 1 is correct, because this is platform 1 and that's platform 4. On the Just Trains one, it has it the other way around, which is wrong. Something to say. This does have a passenger view, as you can see. Very nice looking. So you can even see the door shut. So yeah, it's very nicely looking, and it's pretty much my first time really going along this route and seeing what it's like. So nice to share it with everyone on YouTube. Yeah, fair result. I'm saying obviously we're going to be going on the relief line in a bit. Our next stop is Newport, so of course we've got Newport and in Cardiff Central, the service. There is the Great Western Railways, HST, in the Great Western Railways livery, the new livery of theirs. There we go. So just getting into the right thing. Originally I was planning to drive on the Western Main Line, just changed Western Main Line route scenario. I noticed there was an update for that yesterday, and I downloaded it and put it on the computer, and like before, I've never been able to get one of the scenarios that came with most of the scenarios, pretty much all the scenarios that came with the route working. They never worked out of the box kind of style at all, which was a shame. And so it was always a bit of a pain in the ass, like when playing the game, playing that route, like I would have to make scenarios for it. Anyway, when I went in and tried out a scenario with the update recently, it worked perfectly yesterday. Lovely at all. Tried on two scenarios, worked fine. Started driving one of the scenarios, learned a bit of the route, and I pretty much drove it from near enough the whole scenario all the way from London Paddington to Cardiff Central on the rugby, on the Rugex services. So the rugby specials. Today, I came along to go and do it today, to record it, for you lovely people to watch and everything, and be able to like look at that route all the way from London Paddington. I was going to split into two points, so we would have watched it from London Paddington to Swindon, and in the next part, I was hoping to bring out, do it, and then either bring it out on next Friday, or even Monday, as it's a bank holiday, and have you, so you could be able to all watch it and pretty much enjoy the whole thing. Anyway, today I came along to do it, failed, just will not load it. It just, Railworks just keeps dumping the files. As soon as you load up, you just get a black texture and just get the bar, which you can see down the bottom right as we speak right now, the hub bar. That's it. All you saw the whole time was there, and it was a shame. It was an utter shame. I was looking forward to it, and it just didn't work. So I've just skipped over to this because I thought this will work. Little things I've noticed is missing. Normally there's a footbridge by here, and they haven't got it. They've got the footbridge here, but then that bridge is wrong. It's not as it is. So, beginning along the relief line, we can enjoy looking at the scenery, and I can point out what's wrong and what isn't. And we can pretty much all enjoy this route. I did say for a while I was going to get this route. Look, see what is right, what is not. I looked, did it on the just changed mainline, Western mainline, went all the way to Newport, from Bristol to Newport. Of course, I never got on further than that because there was a problem with the scenario and my, well, there was a problem with my computer at the time, so I couldn't, hard drive was failing, so I couldn't really do the whole scenario to Cardiff. So you only saw a small little part of the whole thing. So I was hoping with this we'd make a new thing and then show the whole thing along, and then we could have gone in a bit more to see this pretty much going over the same route, as it's a different route, but then we could compare the two routes together. Sadly saying that hasn't happened, so, but I'll try and make a route scenario on that route very shortly. Just going under the road bridge, going as the southern going towards Tesco's and Lambourne, and the Southern Distribution Road, as it's known as. As we're going very, we're just coming up to Bishton Flyover. None of them have made Bishton Flyover exactly as Bishton Flyover is in real life. You'd expect these would, dovetail would, but no, they've just made a bridge, copied up a bridge and made a bridge like it, but it's not how the flyover is in real life. The flyover is very much very narrow, very single track and very concrete style. I have got a video from the road bridge we not long got along of trains going around it, and I will put that I'll put that as a link in this video, so we can all also see what it's like in real life. Two-tone horn, separate tones, of course. So yeah, we're going along. See, we're just going along the relief lines of the line to Newport. Thrashing it along. Because this has passenger view, which is beautiful. I did show that a minute ago. It thrashed lovely in there. It does look like we're in a completely separate branch line. Like, we're just merged off from the other line and going a different, totally different way. But yeah, we join on in a sec at Bishton Crossing. By there's Tesco's and Wilkinson's and all in the containers. There's Bishton signal box, still there at the moment, and level crossing. Level crossing is not right, it's a gated level crossing, it's an old fashioned gated level crossing. And that's where the signal box is there. You gotta get permission across. Line now going over to the to Lambourne. Of course, Bishton over there. Let's have a quick run over to Lambourne. Not really got the lines prop nicely to it, but not really accurate. They've just quickly thrown some textures in. It's just a shame, disappointing. We're going to be late into Newport the way we're going. The church is there, it wasn't there in the Just Change version, if you remember when I was showing you before. Isn't a spa church though, so a bit inaccurate, but you know, at least they've put it there unlike the Just Change version. Gonna be a bit late, yeah. Too busy sightseeing more than anything and chatting. As we're going along on the slow lines, and nothing really catching us along, we'll have a look at the hub. So, at the moment, it's showing us Newport Station. There's Newport. We'll move on down to right down to the other end, really. So, here's Bristol Temple Meads and St Philip's Marsh Depot. Barrow Hill Depot here. So, that's the line from Bath. That's the line down to Exeter. We run up here, and of course, here's the branch off to Avonmouth and Severn Beach branch. Of course, we have Stapleton Road here and Lawrence Hill, just by there. Filton Abbey Wood, and there's the lovely crossover junction, because if you're going from Filton Abbey out straight on, you cross along there. Just going to have a look, being overtaken by HST. Straight on, Patray here, Bristol Parkway here, and of course that line is down to Avonmouth, because it's a beautiful triangle, beautiful way of setting up. Severn Tunnel right by here, as you can see. Sorry, not Severn Tunnel, that is Patray Tunnel, because there's Patray. There's Filton, so there's... Oh, what the knife is doing? There's Pilming Station, so yeah, it is Severn Tunnel. Looking along, because you have the little branch tunnel before going under the main tunnel. Coming up, and we've got Cadicot there, which we just went through, in Severn Tunnel Junction, which we also stopped at. There's us, of course, and HST that was just went past us. This is Lambourne, which you can see all the track and lovely done inside. Usmouth Branch, of course, they haven't done the Usmouth Branch down, which is a shame. Usky Shard. This is a line up to the marches, and this is Newport Station, of course. The tunnels outside of Newport. Hillfield, I think it's Hillfield. Tunnels. The line up here to Ebervale, and of course you've got the spur coming down Park Junction by here, where my arrow is. ADJ, Alexander Dock Junction by here, and Ebu Junction, pretty much. Line coming along for the freight yard, and looks like they've done the docks, which is be interesting in driving around. Line all the way on down, because you have the, as you can see, Wentalog freight yard depot there. Just being passed by Class 7, a bit of thrashing. Keep an eye on my speed at the moment, I'm doing alright. Just have a look around where we are. Oh, we're just going to go past land we used to extend all the way down here, and of course it's all gone by here being built. And of course they put the housing estate in, which still isn't being built at all yet. Golf course pretty much on the side of us now. So I'm going to be coming into Newport, so I'll just quickly finish off what I'm doing. That goes down to the scrap yard. Here is Cardiff Bay, Cardiff Queen Street here, Cardiff Central and Canton. Lines down here to Barry and the lines onwards towards Bath. These are lines to the valleys. So there we go, that was a quick little run through on the map as we're going to come along, just so we can see the scenery, not just look at the map as we go along. So we're lovely going along, very wet day, just going to go over the underneath the SDR bridge, which is known as, by the Orway, and of course the line from Lamworm just comes, joins onto us by here. It's normally around about here, but they haven't got it. And of course, this is all Moreland Park. I think you might have remembered from, if you remember on the Just Change one video, that's all bare and in it comes houses, isn't it? Which wasn't realistic. I think I brought it up. Of course, the pub is not there, which has got burnt down, and the retail park down there, which is accurate now. All the way in the corner. Be Liswary Ponds in a bit, which is. We'll have a quick run to. Speed limit's just gone up. There we go, Liswary Ponds. Looks quite nice, but you wouldn't want to go there in real life. It's not the most nicest place around. It's nice and pretty, but you do get the misbehaving kids there, to be honest. So yeah, we've just gone past Moreland Park and all. Speeding up a bit because we are 60 miles per hour now. Warning, this is 10 mile per hour crossover into the yard. You may have noticed I'm keeping the hub up, I'm just keeping an eye on what we're doing as we're looking for scenery. Definitely going to be late into Newport Station. This is Somerton Bridge, of course that's not accurate with Somerton Bridge. If it's the old version, it's an arch bridge here and then the corrugated. Then it's just steel thing. New one they've just built it. It's all concrete, but yeah, it still has a arch in a bit. You wouldn't have a span that long. It's too long, to be honest. So that was a bit inaccurate. Now going past Uskey's yard. Houses along the side, on one side, all the terrace houses. These are going on a bit too much, these houses on the corner. We're standard speed now, so this. Get on, break on. He's just brakes on this. And new housing estate that's being built on the old Pirelli site. EMS going off. I forgot there's the 40 coming up. Too busy sightseeing. Just going over the Bridge Wharf Road, and I didn't look like. No, there isn't. There's no George Street Bridge, which is a shame. That's a bit inaccurate. Well. Ladies and gentlemen, this isn't a scoring point one at all. This is just me pretty much looking around the route, as you can tell. Going over at Maesteg, which is quite accurate with the petrol station. Not houses along there, it's all shops. There's the line up to the marches. Tax office in the corner, as you could just see, at least that's there. The other one, it wasn't there at all. Going over Clear Road. So we're slowly coming in, slowing over the 20 now. Cross over the other road bridge, a little road that goes underneath. Can remember that was in the other one. Car park, which wasn't in the Just Change one at all, is in this one. Nice cloud-based car park and cloud-based tower. Cloud-based tower looks a lot different than what that shows. Newport Castle looks exactly what Newport Castle looks like, and that looks like Newport Bridge and the Wave. It does look accurate, but that doesn't look like the Riverfront Theatre. That still doesn't look like old Sainsbury's, and, well, it just looks a bit poor looking down there on the river, which is a shame, lets it down a little. Coming in now into Newport on Platform 1. We came into Platform 1 last time we were on this, on the Western Main Line, so back into Platform 1 again. I have to admit, the post office doesn't really look like that. Much different than that, and I think that building on the side, yep, that's not accurate. It's a car park and a building, and that doesn't look like that. Come on, brakes on. Old Newport Station building looks very accurate, and Newport Station looks accurate indeed. Pardon me, sorry about that. That's supposed to be Admiral's Tower, and it doesn't really look like that. So they haven't really... I can see a lot of reusing textures here. And compared to this route, it's much smaller than the Western Main Line, and pretty much the same price as the Western Main Line, you would expect it to be in better quality, to be honest. And higher in detail. Don't know why the HST's over there with a green light. It should go the other way. So, yeah, this is Newport Station. Looks quite accurate, to be honest. Newport Station, as it looks like what it looks like in real life. Get a quick photo before we leave. Door shut. Don't think the car's buzzing us anymore. Well, it seems like the sounds are a bit not... Maybe just me, but I never think the sound is the best on this. Sounds like it could be a bit better. They don't sound too bad, but they just sound a little bit wishy-washy a little. Just an improvement on the sounds could help that. So we're going to go... Already standard speed. So here we're going to go through the Hillfield tunnels now. As this just put it, is Newport tunnels, down relief. This one is the older tunnel than that one. That one's a more of a newer one. Sorry, just jumping out. No, it did. I was making sure it had the footbridge, and that HST just coming out of the wrong platform, pretty much. That would have gone out of platform 2, not platform 3. Platform 2 would have been for services to London Paddington and towards Bristol. It generally goes 2 and 3 and 4, going towards east, going either to north at the marches or eastway. Going east, so to Bristol, Cheltenham, Gloucester, Birmingham, Nottingham, London Paddington, Taunton, all the places that you would go that way. And they would use 1 and 2 going the opposite way, except if there's engineering works between engineering works, and then they will use it the other way round. So 2 would be out. 2 would be towards, down towards Cardiff, and 4 would be the up towards London Way and all. So, but yeah, it was a bit weird. That line doesn't go up, and so that's inaccurate. I've seen it on the Just Change Road, that line creeps up to the tunnel. They've made that flat, which is wrong. It's not flat, that is a gradient. So, you know, from here, and I got a video from here, and you can see that is a gradient. So they've done that wrong. Which is a shame, I'm disappointed. It's a shame they haven't got that right a little, you know. Would have been better if that was a bit more accurate. Gonna go through ADJ now. Alexander Dock Junction. With the docks down there. I think I have a quick fly down. Alright, the line's there, but the docks isn't. Okay, that was a bit... I was hoping for a bit of secret running then, but no, obviously not. I will rely off someone actually designing the docks then. It's a bit of a shame. Freight liner trains, wagons waiting to move along. This is very much non freight. This is more EWS, that yard, not freight liner. But there we go. HST overtaken us, and we got the 175, which comes with the route, going past as well. So, a bit of a rundown now. Of course, I never came along this far down on the Western Main Lines, which, like I said, I was hoping I could do, but sad to say, unable to. So, I'll have to try and make a scenario sometime soon, running all the way down to Cardiff, and we can so we can experience the whole route pretty much as well, and have a look to see in more detail downwards this way. 60 mile per hour, so this speed us up again. Running late, of course. This is definitely not a points run, so we won't be going on that. It's more of a look through. Looking at the beautiful sceneries and textures of this route. AWS going off. So yeah, it was a thing. I was also saying about, like, of course I was on holiday in Cyprus for the last 2 weeks. You may have noticed my video... There was a video put up yesterday, and that was my video from last Friday. I set my phone, set it up to run every Friday, and all I had to do was just overlook it on my phone. When I looked on Friday to have a overlook to see if it had gone live, it didn't say it was live, so I pushed the button to like, make it public and live and all for everyone to see, and on my phone it said it was live. So I set it out, thought it was all done. It was only when I came home, when I came on the computer on Thursday, just to come on the computer, sort everything out and everything like that, I looked on YouTube, and I noticed one live, so I'm very sorry for the delay on that video. I know it's kind of like there's a video yesterday and it would be a video today, so there's two videos that are coming up quite frequently in a row, but I was a bit annoyed with that then. I was hoping it all to work quite smoothly, and obviously it didn't, so sorry about that. I suppose it's a little bonus treat then with the bank holiday that you can watch it. Notice the blinds don't come down on this. You can watch the lovely two videos around. So, gone along now, very flat lands between Newport and Cardiff. Pretty much the wetlands this is. Well, not wetlands, it's all flat lowland. Be going through, in a bit, going through Marshfield. Quite a few of these bridges are quite good ones to take photos off and all. Very quiet roads, quite a lot of them, and nice places you can pull up and able to do some videos or photography of the trains going by between Newport and Cardiff. So we've gone along nicely, 7.3 miles to Cardiff Central, going along quite nicely. But yeah, as like I was saying as well, Cyprus, lovely place, lovely country. If anyone's never been, would advise you to go. Lovely place. My partner's never been to Cyprus before, so she was looking forward to this holiday and going there, and it was, we did go a lot to the tourist places and see, show her all the stuff, and there was little bits I went to as well I wanted to do, and yeah, it was enjoyable, very fun, very enjoyable. Like I said, I would recommend to anyone to go. Cyprus is always a weird country, because especially if you go to the Greek side, of course they speak Greek, and but they drive on the same side of the road as Britain does. If you've ever been to Cyprus, you probably would agree, it's very, how can you put it, it's very much not Britain, but is Britain. If you've ever been there, you probably get a kind of an idea what I'm talking about. There's a lot of British stuff there, like they say, drive on the same side of the road, a lot of the phone, if you see the post boxes, they're very much like the British standard post box. It's a lot of stuff that's very British style, because it was a British colony. But it's not British, it's very Greek as well. So it's a weird, weird place, but they're amazing place to go to. Like, I would recommend to anyone to go and to go there. I think we've gone past Marshfield. I didn't really see it. Normally you'd see a little bit of quite a few houses. And secondly, there would have been a horn, as a sound of a horn, a W board. So you would have had to W board. Now, I don't know if I've missed it, but I didn't see it at all, because we are now, we've gone well and truly past it, because we're pretty much coming into Cardiff now, because that is Rentaloo Yard now. So, yeah, that was a bit disappointing. There's something that was missing from this then. Sorry if it seems like I'm very negative finding points. I do like to see stuff as quite accurate as I can in areas, especially when you live there. You do know, you pick up more than anyone else, anything else. But just little things I do like to see to make sure it's as it should be. Start point step one with braking on. Slow down for the 40. Yeah, no, like I said, Cyprus is a lovely place. I always, like, these days you could walk across no man's land in at Nicosia, like there's the border control, and so you could go to the Turkish side, the northern side of Cyprus. And of course, when I went there, Cyprus, 12 years ago, you couldn't do that. There was points where you could look over no man's land, and it was an eerie sight to see. Like, you'd see like abandoned buildings, like bullet holes in the walls on the sides. It was very eerie to see. But like today, it's very different. And Nicosia was a lovely place to go. When I was there, it was commercialised on the outside, like very big, huge high street names and this, that, and the other. But when you got into the old town, the old city, through the old city walls, everything was like very oldie style. Like, you had the you'd had like independent shops and everything. But when I went to Nicosia this time, it's changed. It's gone very too commercialised, and I feel like the character which there was there 12 years ago has gone, which I was disappointed about. I was looking forward to that lovely old fashioned, like, there's a modern city, but here's the typical, the character that many places got rid of. And it got rid of it, and I was disappointed. Don't get me wrong, when I went to the Turkish side, I found that Audi style and everything I was looking forward to when I was on the thing. And it was sad to say, I enjoyed being on the Turkish side than the Greek side, because the Greek side had got too commercialised. It lost its character, which was a shame. But maybe I would say I prefer to like looking at Turkish side, because it's the first time you're going to be over there. The border, it's been open for a bit, but not too long, so it's not going to be as commercialised as the... Yeah, it's not going to be as commercialised as the other side. So, you know, end of the day, you know, slightly different. But yeah, it was. It did seem like it was lost. It had changed too much. But I wouldn't say you never go there. I would always recommend you to go there, because you can either go to Cyprus and not go to Nicosia. It's very much an important place in the history of Cyprus. The whole border line in the whole country and all. It's a very important place. Coming into Cardiff now, as you can tell. We're going along past the shops now, along Newport Road, pretty much. As you can see, we only got like 2.4 miles to go now into Cardiff Central. Going to be on time into Cardiff Central, quarter to our ETA. So, caught up a bit of time. But like I said, don't expect good scores. I'm not really doing this one for scoring. I'm pretty much doing a little catch-up video, having a good chat with you all, and saying about how everything was, and what we think of the route. What I see, like, bits are missing from the route and everything. Sure, but most of these places are very generic, standard, like, you know, they are a bit generic shops, but you do get the certain ones that are slightly different than others, and it's kind of missing. Double amber light I can see ahead. Bridge going across. Road bridge. Oh, just gone green, so pretty much going to be cleared along in. So yeah, like I said, it was, I should say, on the corner, on the side of us now, pretty much Splow, going from Splow now, or Splot, as the English would say, Splow, but yeah, it's pretty much said as Splot. People always say it wrong. Talk to someone who's trying to be posh, oh, I live in Splow, doesn't, yeah, it's not a posh place at all. So, going along nicely now, double amber. As you can see on the hub below, 50 mile per hour speed limit going to be coming up soon. AWS. So, going along nicely. But yeah, like I said, I do recommend anyone. If you've never been to Cyprus, go. You'll enjoy it. Very nice place, very nice country, a very friendly country in that manner as well. It was an enjoyable holiday. Didn't want to come back, as always, as you always do feel like that in holidays, of course. But yeah, back again, back to doing videos. I'd love it if I had a place over there, and I'd probably live quite happily. So there's the Cardiff skyline coming up in front of us now. AWS. The first step of braking on. There's going to be a red coming up in a bit. Warning for the 15 mile per hour speed restriction. Well, the university building doesn't really. Kind of like that, but not really like that. So that's just generic as anything. Just reusing textures. Normally you'd see right by there, because you can see the line going up to Cardiff, Cardiff Queen Street, because you would see the Motorpoint Arena pretty much here, but of course not there. Footbridge is accurate. That's the new footbridge they have put on, higher than the original one that was here for the electrification, and of course student union, the student accommodations in the corner. That building is definitely very, very much accurate. It is like that. If anyone watched Tortured, you would recognise that building. So we're looking around Cardiff, and it's pretty much all right. You see, we've got an amber light coming up, so a bit of a cheating that was. line from the valleys just coming in now, crossing over from Cardiff Green Street, coming in. Yeah, we're nicely coming into the Cardiff. Quick look about here, remember, yeah. Of course, there'd be offices here, quite modern offices. It's looking alright, it's looking quite accurate, but not fully accurate, you know what I mean? That building looks much older than what's actually there. It's quite a newish building. A lot of this was all new builds around here in Cardiff, so. Pretty much look up St Mary Street here. It looks alright. More impressive than it looking down the river from Newport. It's like they're missing a lot of textures. Millennium Stadium, you could probably see, and the building next to it. So yeah, now coming into Cardiff Central Station. A nice enjoyable trip that was. Coming into Cardiff early. Slow us down nicely now. Roll up a bit. Slow down a bit too much. We'd stop at the stop end as you continue on to Maesteg. Now, they will put a train, pulling a train behind you. What we do? I don't know if there's any stop markers on this platform. They do have stop markers. Millennium Stadium and the Water Tower. Okay, the brakes just slammed on then, so that went good. AWS. But there's over the doors. That's pretty much the scenario done. Well, that's inaccurate. You wouldn't have that one of those over there. No way. New platform and all for Cardiff Central. That's pretty decent. No, you can't really get a shot from the next stadium, so I'll just leave it at that. So there we go, that's our little run down to Cardiff Central for, well, pretty much Cardicot. Continuing. Nice work, driver. This service will continue on down to Maesteg, but you are no longer required. Let's see how you did. We can see below, 650, not that good score. Of course, I wasn't in it to really do scores today. I was in it to just explore and look at the route. So, yeah, it was alright. It was enjoyable. Nice and enjoyable little run. Probably do a few more scenarios on this route, upload it. Probably do another one, like I said, on the Western Main Line, of course. As always, like I have said before, I will try and do it. But yeah, hopefully you enjoyed that. Lovely little video coming back in. Come back on to this game. And coming back off holiday. I'll definitely try and keep getting videos up. Oh yeah, if anyone's asking, I have recently downloaded a new game. Which I may try and do a video of. Or might have a look around. Free game on Steam, but I'll let you look. I'll probably talk about it a bit more in the next video, or when I do a video, and all like that. But yeah, it's enjoyable. So yeah, until next time. Hope you enjoyed that. Please don't forget to comment and put a like if you enjoyed this video. Comment, of course. I would reply to your comments as soon as you can. Don't forget, you can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Link below in the description. Like I said, I would also put in the description a video as well of what Bishop Flyover looks like from one of my videos, when I videoed it in when I had my video camera with me one of the times. But yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed that video. So yeah, till next time, ladies and gentlemen, hope you enjoyed, and bye for now.